A DAO is an organization that is owned by its online community. There isn't a specific group of people like a board of directors. Instead, every member of the DAO has an equal vote in every decision. Imagine if every position of power in a traditional company, like the CEO, were removed and the power was given to its shareholders.
At least it'll help level the playing field.
These shareholders would now vote on every decision the company makes and would receive a proportional share of the company's profits.
I thought we were an autonomous collective.
Corporate accountability.
We have a corporate responsibility which extends to thousands of shareholders.
Not fair.
Dad says the shareholders.
I've got the power.
Control yourself.
I betrayed the shareholders.
It's getting kind of hectic.
Power to the people.
Autonomous organization.
Sounds good.
A DAO decentralizes its decision-making by releasing governance tokens. These tokens give holders the power to vote on proposals on-chain. For example, what to do with the money in the DAO's treasury.
I make my own money, so I spend it how I like.
Some of the benefits of DAOs are on-chain transparency for its entire structure, skin in the game for every member, and the immutability offered by the blockchain.
It's self-funded and managed by the stakeholders.
This stops other organizations or individuals from being able to interfere once the decisions are made.
The more you're going to find out.
But with no central decision makers to guide the organization in the right direction, a DAO could stunt growth and innovation. Even minor decisions must be voted on, which could make any kind of change take much longer than necessary.
It's a high price we pay for respectability.
It's also a common misperception that community members always know what's best for the organization that they're a part of. Steve Jobs once famously said that Apple's job is not to give customers what they want, but to figure out what they're going to want before they do. Governance tokens can also be traded on the public market, which gives rise to another issue.
I hope you're ready for a takeover.
A malicious actor could plan a takeover by buying up these tokens and single-handedly determining the outcome of proposals.
It also proves another saying:
power corrupts.
And absolute power corrupts absolute.
Will you shut up?
Riker out.
This kind of takeover is made easier by the fact that most DAOs have horrible attendance when it comes to governance, probably because most holders only bought in to speculate on the token's price.
Look, I'm just here for the money.
Build Finance was a DAO that sought to support new venture projects, but in February this year, someone managed to acquire enough of their governance token called Build and took over the DAO by being the majority voter on a proposal.
Vote. What is a vote?
They minted over 1 million Build tokens and drained every liquidity pool to oblivion, which effectively killed the project.
Who's in charge over there?
Build Finance's domain is now for sale. So takeovers pose an existential threat to DAOs that don't plan ahead for these types of events. A potential remedy for this is to decentralize power by distributing soulbound governance tokens that can't be traded or transferred. Watch our video on soulbound tokens here to learn more about that. For now though, DAOs appear to function better, perhaps as a tool to decentralize and automate smaller projects. For example, a Web3 app whose token emission is governed by its holders, or a grants platform where its members decide which projects receive funding. But for sure, we'll be hearing a lot more about DAOs in the future. Thanks for watching, everyone. We've got a lot more videos for you, so click any of these videos so you can keep watching. And don't forget to like if you liked it and sub if you dug it.